In this video, I'll show you how you can simply drag a reference to a Unity scene via the inspector and not have to worry about its name changing or its order in the build settings, scenes in build, also known as build index. If you've ever wanted to be able to serialize a Unity scene in the inspector, rather than use a string reference or build index, this is the video for you. I came across this issue in my own game, Epic Adventure Quest, where I have items such as books that, when used, trigger a scene load. At first, I would assign a string reference to the scene's name in the item's scriptable object. This works fine, but is prone to error, and I may want to change the name of scene as I develop the game, and I don't want to have to re-edit or check hundreds of items if I do. Wouldn't it be great if I could just drag in a reference to the scene object directly in the inspector like any other game object? That is exactly what I did. I created a serialized field of type scene asset called scene to load. And then, when my item was used and I called the level manager to load scene, I passed in the scene to load dot name and convert that to string. And well, although this all works when testing the game in editor, Unity does not support this when it comes time to make a build. You will get the following error in the console. Error CS0246. The type or namespace name scene asset could not be found. Are you missing a using directive or assembly reference? The error message is an indication that the compiler doesn't know what scene asset is, which is likely because you're using it in a non-editor script. Scene asset is part of the Unity editor namespace, which is stripped out when you build your game. It only exists in the editor. So here is the workaround. Using compiler directives to separate editor-only code from runtime code. #if_unity_editor. This will allow the code within the directive to be compiled only for the editor, and it will be ignored in the build. So what we do is change my scene asset reference back to a string type, and we'll change the name of it to scene to load path for clarity. Then we'll create a compiler directive block of code with #if_unity_editor. And inside this, we'll create a new property called scene to load with a capital S and get to return the path of the scene asset and set to fill out the string scene to load path. You can see an example here of what the return will look like. But it is not that simple, because Unity does not automatically display properties in the inspector for non-serialized fields or properties. What you can do, though, is create a custom editor script that will allow us to show the scene to load property in the inspector and be able to drag and drop the scene asset in. In this example, this simple script draws the default inspector and then adds a property called scene to load, which is of type scene asset. Just make sure to save this script inside a folder called editor. Now on our item or whichever game object you're using to store a scene reference, we can see when we populate the scene to load field, we can see the string above it become populated with the path to the scene asset. Now when we use Unity's scene manager load scene method, we only need to pass in a build index or string name, so we can simply create a function to convert our scene asset's path back to a simple name with the following. Here in our convert scene path to name method, we pass in the scene to load path string. We create an integer called start and using last index of. We get a reference to the last forward slash in the path, plus 1 to account for starting at index 0. We create another integer called end, and again last index of gets a reference to the last full stop or period before the file extension Unity. Now using these two integers, we can essentially cut out the scene name from the path using the substring method and return it. Now we have a much less error-prone and more user-friendly way to set which level we want to use, and we can still make a build of game and everything just works fine. If you found this video helpful or interesting, please give it a like and consider subscribing for more game dev tips and updates on my own game and assets. There are links to the Discord channel in the description below. Thanks for watching. Until next time.